Hey everyone, today we're going to follow a tutorial on how to create your own store locator for your business. And we're going to do it using the TomTom Maps APIs. Let's take a look.
At the end of this tutorial, you can select the store or the city and see where it is located in the map. Alternatively, you can select the store in the map and see the details in the left panel. Okay, before we start, we need three things first. An API key from the TomTom developer portal, a list of your store locations, and then convert that list into a JSON format so we can display them on a map. And after that, we go over with how to display the map, add the markers, add and organize the stores, we add some interactivity, and use the JQuery accordion widget. As usual, getting the API key is very easy. Visit us at developer.tomtom.com, and after registration, no credit card needed, go to your dashboard where you can find your newly created API key. I assume you already have a list of your store locations. In this example, we'll take them from our tutorial in GitHub. In this sample, we have a list from two cities, and the file is already in GeoJSON format. Take a look at the description down below. Interesting point now is that some companies have been adding to the map some close-by attractions or point of interest. In this way, it's easier for the user to locate a store physically. In order to do this, we use the TomTom Search API. To be exact, we want to search for POIs or point of interest depending on your industry. For example, if you are mapping shoe stores and they are on a pedestrian-only area, we can add markers with parks or touristic attractions around them to help guide your customer. Take a look at the documentation link in the description for more information. Let's start by initializing the map. Looking at this minimal HTML template, we see the head section contains now the CSS and SDKs downloaded from the TomTom CDN, or Content Distribution Network, and of course the JavaScript jQuery library. Next, we have the body with one section for the city selector and another for the map itself. And finally, we see here how to add the map object. This is probably the easiest way to do it. Like I mentioned before, we have the store list in a GeoJSON format already in a file. We included this file to the project as a JavaScript object. Then, we can loop over the list and create markers for each one of the elements. Note that we are adding them to the map immediately. Of course, it's important to mention that every element of the store needs at least a city. We need to know what is the address of the store, of course, and its location in Latin long coordinates. To add the list, or in this case, the cities where these stores are, we get from each element the city, and we add it to the respective section in our initial HTML. Now, if the HTML element doesn't exist, that means we found a new city, and we create a new element internally and insert the store data there. Additionally, we can add an event listener to the city section. So when we click on it, we zoom the map to encompass all the stores in that city. Again, don't forget to check this tutorial from our developer portal. For interactivity, we added click listeners to zoom on the map when a specific store from the sections is clicked. And also we make sure to close pop-ups if any other markers have been engaged before. The accordion widget in jQuery allows us to organize the cities in logical sections, much like a browser tab. In order to activate it, we use the accordion function attached to an HTML element. In this case, it's the store list element. We set the sections collapsible, of course, and we add some icons. And this will take us to the end of this tutorial. Our store locator for Amsterdam and Rotterdam is finished. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you for watching and happy mapping!